episode of View from the Bridge, which brings you face to face with the leaders of the maritime world. Today, we are extremely proud to be joined by Director of the Regions, ISWAN, Mr. Chirag Bari. ISWAN India has always been instrumental when it comes to the well-being of Indian seafarers. Let's talk with Mr. Bari to gain some insight on the role of ISWAN and the beneficiaries of their pro-sailor policies, especially the Seafarer Emergency Fund, or SPF, which aims to help the Indian seafarers financially when they need the most.
Hello everyone. I'm very thankful to Sailor today for inviting me in their episode View from Bridge. I'm very pleased to be part of this initiative and would like to draw upon some of the initiatives which ISWAN has been taking during this COVID-19 pandemic period in supporting seafarers and their families.
We came to know that ISWAN recently supported Savio, an assistant waiter onboard cruise ship who was initially suffering from tumor, which later developed into cancer. My question to you is, did the employer came to the seafarer rescue, or ISWAN India has to muster its own resources to help the ailing crew? Also, how did the family respond?
A couple of years back, ISWAN was approached by the family of seafarer Mr. Xavier Farrow. We learned from them that Mr. Farrow, who used to work on cruise vessels, had undergone and he has been diagnosed with the tumor in his head, and later that developed into cancer. The family was shattered. The dreams of the seafarer was, you know, he could not imagine anything that what will happen to him and his family. Obviously, he was at home, so he could not be covered under any kind of medical agreements, any contractual obligations on the owners or the employer. And therefore, the seafarer's family was quite worried on how to continue the treatment of the seafarer amid lesser financial scope available with them. When we came in touch with the family, we inquired from them about various scenarios, and we also approached the employer, who graciously mentioned that he could have helped, but since the seafarer was not on ship, they were finding it difficult to help the seafarer. ISWAN then approached the Seafarers Emergency Fund to provide immediate financial support to the family so that they can continue the treatment of Mr. Xavier Farrow, who needed radiotherapy and other medical support immediately. His chemotherapy was also done during the course of time. Luckily, the grant was provided for Mr. Farrow, and his treatment is still ongoing. I think this is a very unique example of how not only that the financial money was provided, but every moment of thing, family, even though we have nothing to do after 2 years, since the grant was obviously provided to the family on them, but then still we are in touch with the family members. We are always connected to them. Still, he is undergoing for any test, and the family approaches us, share the report, which is very encouraging. The reports are getting better and better every time, and we are very hopeful that Mr. Xavier Farrow will again recover very soon. I would also like to mention here about the role of his sister. She is just standing by her brother like a rock. Just like a rock, and she's just supporting him with everything and anything come her way. She has her own family to look after, but at the same time, half of her time goes into looking after his ailing brother and as well his old mother as well. I would really appreciate and salute the woman in power, that she's been driving and she's been looking after her brother like anything, and because of that, the brother has now been able to recover to some extent from the ongoing issues that he's been faced. Unfortunately, he's been going through it. We are very hopeful that he will recover soon, and we wish him a very, very speedy recovery. Thank you.
What provisions does ISWAN India offer for supporting the crew financially when they or their family are involved in an unforeseeable circumstances as far as healthcare is concerned? I also wanted to ask you, how did Swan India came to the rescue of Vinay Kumar, whose family needed an immediate medical assistance?
During this ongoing pandemic, a few of the seafarers, they have approached Swan, mentioning that their families have been undergoing a lot of trauma because they do not have any source of income. They could not join the ship, and as such, they could not provide the medical support to their families. Swan Seafarers Emergency Fund has come to rescue for some of these seafarers. One of the cases was about Mr. Vinay Singh. He signed up from the ship, and because his wife was not well and his child was also not well at the same time. After he reached home, he tried to provide them the medical support locally, but then he was referred to come to Delhi for further medical advice and treatment of his wife. During this period, the government also announced a lockdown and various other set of procedures came in. The seafarer was finding very difficult to continue the treatment. However, the seafarer came in touch with Swan, and we guided the seafarer. We also filled up his application so that he can, from the Seafarers Emergency Fund, from which the grants were awarded to look after the medical treatment of his wife as well as child during its ongoing pandemic crisis. The seafarer's wife is now recovering very well. His child is totally fine, and we're really pleased that the Seafarers Emergency Fund was able to help the seafarer in the need of crisis. This Seafarers Emergency Fund is not available for a long-term benefits. It is only provided to seafarers for their urgent medical needs or urgent requirements, as the case may be. So therefore, and no money from this Seafarers Emergency Fund shall be given to the seafarers or their families in direct cash. It has to be given for a purpose for which it has been applied for.
We have been informed that Swan India has been truly instrumental in the treatment of a seafarer from Thoothukudi district in Tamil Nadu, Iruthaya Mishilraj, who is suffering from end-stage renal failure from past 1 year. My question to you is, how did you manage to get his employer on board and provide proper medical assistance to him?
A couple of months back, we were approached by a Tuticorin-based seafarers welfare organization who mentioned that one of their member seafarer is suffering from kidney issue, and this particular trouble has been ongoing from almost a year now. The seafarer, issue came in on board ship, and therefore they have also approached their company as well as a P&I club to look after the medical support. Due to the pandemic crisis happened, the lot of organizations have reduced their working hours, and the money was not been able to dispatch out to the seafarer to continue his treatment. When we came to know about this, Swan immediately stepped in, and in order that the seafarer should be able to continue his treatment and there should be no hamper towards his medical condition, Swan's Seafarers Emergency Fund was approached, and a small amount of grant was provided to the seafarer during this period so that he can continue his dialysis, his treatment till the time the P&I club was able to then award the rest of the grants. This has helped the seafarer for at least a couple of months to continue his treatment. His family was very, very tensed that how, because in the last 1 year they have spent a lot of money in the ongoing procedures, and also that the seafarer is not able to earn money. He's very young, he's just below 30 years of age. And in this time, if a seafarer develops this kind of a fatal disease, it is very disastrous for a family. And not only we provided them with the financial support, we also work very closely with the Mission to Seafarers local chaplain, who helped the family to during this all this period. He provided them with emotional support, looked after the family, and is also standby with them during this hour of crisis. So the Seafarers Emergency Fund does provide the financial support, but the important factor here is that the emotional support was also provided to the family at all the stages during this period of time. I wish the seafarer very, very quick recovery And I'm sure that this company and the P&I Club will definitely look after all the various issues which the seafarers and the family is ongoing.
We have come across the case of one Mr. Singh who developed heart blockage at a young age of 34, and we came to know that ISWAN India came to his rescue. Not only he was given proper medical assistance, but his family expenses for his prescribed bed duration too were taken care of. So can you please elaborate a bit about Seafarer Emergency Fund and what all expenses are included in the grant if approved?
In another case, Mr. Singh approached ISWAN for financial grants. Mr. Singh had suffered a heart problem when he was 34 years of age. It was when he was on board ship, he developed heart trouble and he was medically signed off. His company looked after him very, very well. He was operated upon after returning home, and all the expenses were being paid by the company as per his contract. However, it was finding very difficult for the seafarer to continue his livelihood means, and because of his ongoing treatment, he could not join the ship as well. He approached ISWAN if anything can be done to support him for the next 6 months, so as he can gather some time to able to support his children with his school education. His wife is also not able to work because of another medical reasons. And therefore, the seafarer was very, very tense that how he will be able to continue to provide support and livelihood means in this current scenario when he can't work himself, when his family could not support him, and his children will have to continue with their education. ISWAN, as soon as we came to know and we analyzed his troubles and we filled up the Seafarers Emergency Fund application. The grant was provided to him by the advisors. And the CFA was so thankful and grateful towards ISWAN that his family also wrote a thanking message and a small video thanking the organization that they have stepped in and to help to continue the children with their school education. Now the children are able to go back to schools. He has some means of income, or not income, but in the sense that he's been able to now support his livelihood. And he don't have to stress out too much that he can't work. He can continue to look after his medical treatment till the time he recovers fully. His medicines were also quite costly, and that has been also looked after by the Seafarers Emergency Fund for the next 6 months. And we have been very pleased that now Mr. Singh is quite fit. He although cannot join back ship, but he has started his own small work now, and is able to now continue his livelihood and be able to stand on his own. And that is what the main purpose is for the Seafarers Emergency Fund. It is not that just give the financial support. It is also that the seafarer is able to find means to support his family. He can stand on his own and continue to provide further support to his loved ones at home.
Mr. Chirag, my last question to you is, how did ISWAN India come to know about bilateral Wilms tumor of 1 year toddler of Shalabh Sharma? Also, what are the provisions for medical treatment for those who are dependent on seafarers, and how much financial aid can one expect to meet contingencies?
Just before the lockdown, we were unfortunately heard about a seafarer whose very young daughter was suffering from kidney cancer, and when we heard about it, we were really very, very tensed, and it was so difficult for us to even imagine the condition the family was going through. ISWAN approached the Seafarers Emergency Fund again for this case. The seafarer had took loans from his family members, from his friends, to continue the treatment of his daughter. Seafarers Emergency Fund then stepped in and provided substantial amount of funding so that the grants were able to help the seafarer to at least look after some cost towards a surgery and medical treatment of the infant daughter. I don't have words to say anything on this case particularly. This has touched us so much because it's a young, very young child who needed a life support, who needed somebody to help her to again get on the track to fight it out with the odds And it was, I'm so pleased that the daughter is doing better now, although it will take some time for her to recover completely, but it gives us so satisfaction, so relaxed in the evening, that at least something good has happened from the CFS Emergency Fund, that the daughter is now better, and I'm very sure that she will recover fully. This is just not the need, because imagine a young daughter, a family who has gone through such kind of stress, such kind of trauma, and they do not know what to do. The seafarers normally are not insured when they're at home. Normally their families are, even if they're insured, there are so many clauses in that the insurance companies, sometimes they reject the claims as well. And then the seafarer or his family finds it so difficult to find out alternate means on whom to approach, how to approach, which organization will help them when the seafarer is not on board. So I think it's an important awareness thing that the seafarers should be aware of, that they can always approach the CFS Emergency Fund, besides other funds which are available for the seafarers and their families in such scenarios. Apart from CFS Emergency Fund, ISFUND also administers at least two more funds, and that are specifically for the piracy. One is called the Piracy Survivor Family Fund, which is basically administered by ISFUND, but is a contact group on piracy off the coast of Somalia's PSFF fund, which is provided to any seafarer or family who are either affected by incidents of piracy or armed robbery off the coast of Somalia. That is only specifically for those seafarers who have suffered piracy incidents, of those who have been impacted due to piracy incidents off Somalia. There is also one other fund called Maritime Piracy Humanitarian Response Fund, MPHRF, which is available for all seafarers of all nationalities around the world of any kind of piracy incidents that they may have suffered during the course of time. So if the seafarers, suppose nowadays we have seen a lot of piracy incidents happening off the west coast of Africa or in Southeast Asia, if they have been impacted due to it and they need some financial support to look after their counselings or any other kind of urgent support, this fund can be again approached.
Thank you so much, Mr. Bari, for the time you have taken to share your views and updates with us. It is reassuring to know that seafarers are taken care of. Your efforts will go in a long way, providing timely support, assistance and care for them, especially in these difficult times. We hope to connect with you again.
Seafarers of any nationality, whether they belong to any union, whether they are on board ship or whether they are at home, cruise ship, cargo ship, whatever, if they are in need of any grants because of any unforeseen circumstances that they or their family are going through, they can always approach their organization or their unions to put up an application to the Seafarers Emergency Fund. This fund is governed by a set of advisors who look into each and every application with all the details which are mentioned in the application, and rigorously try and support each and every seafarer as best as possible. So seafarers, if you are in need of any kind of support during this ongoing pandemic or otherwise, you can always approach the Seafarers Emergency Fund and more information you can view at www.seafarerswelfare.org. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And to all my friends, we will definitely meet in yet another episode of View from the Bridge. Till then, stay safe and take care.